infrastructure and financial sector development. Infrastructure is the growth driver of the economy. Our country needs massive investment, estimated to be in excess of 50 lakh crores in infrastructure to increase growth of GDP, connect and integrate the nation with a network of roads, airports, railways, ports, inland water, and to provide good quality services to the people. We have made an all-time high allocation in rail and road sector. We have committed to further enhancing public investment. Provision of key linkages like coal for power, power for railways, and railway rakes for coal have been rationalized and made very efficient. Prime Minister personally reviews the targets and the achievements in infrastructure sectors on a regular basis. Using online monitoring system of Pragati alone, projects worth rupees 9.46 lakh crores have been facilitated and fast-tracked. To secure India's defense, we are developing connectivity infrastructure in the border areas. Rohtang Tunnel has been completed to provide all-weather connectivity to the Ladakh region. Contract for the construction of the Jozila Pass Tunnel of more than 14 kilometers is progressing well. I now propose to take up the construction of a tunnel under the Sela Pass. For promoting tourism and emergency medical care, government will make necessary framework for encouraging investment in the seaplane activities. Urbanization is our opportunity and priority. My government has rolled out two interlinked programs, Smart City Mission and the Amrut. Smart City Mission aims at creating 100 smart cities and state-of-art amenities. I am happy to inform that 99 cities have been selected with an outlay of rupees 2.04 lakh crores. These cities have started implementing various projects like Smart City Command Control Center, Smart Roads, Smart Solar Roof, Intelligent Transport Systems, Smart Parks. Projects worth rupees 2,350 crores have been completed, and work of rupees 20,852 crores has been under progress. To preserve and revitalize the soul of the heritage cities of India, National Heritage City Development Augmentation Yojana has been taken up in a major way. India is blessed with an abundance of tourist attractions. It is proposed to develop 10 prominent tourist sites into iconic tourism destinations by following an holistic approach involving infrastructure and skill development, development of technology, attracting private investment, branding and marketing. In addition, tourist amenities at 110 Adarsh monuments in the Archaeological Survey of India will be upgraded to an enhanced visitor experience. The Amrut program focuses on providing water supply to all households in 500 cities. State level plans of rupees 77,640 crores for 500 cities has been approved. Water supply contracts for 494 projects worth rupees 19,428 crores and sewage work contract for rupees 272 projects costing rupees 12,429 crores has been awarded. Reforms have been catalyzed by these missions. 482 cities have started credit ratings. 142 cities have got investment grade ratings. My ministry will leverage the India Infrastructure Finance Corporation to help finance major infrastructure projects, including investment in education, health infrastructure, or strategic and larger societal benefit considerations. The government has scaled new heights in the development of the road infrastructure. We are confident to complete the national highways exceeding 9,000 kilometers during 2017 and 18. The ambitious Bharatmala project has been approved for providing seamless connectivity of interior and backward areas and borders of the country to develop
35,000 kilometers in phase one at an estimated cost of 5,35,000 crores to raise equity from the market for its mature road assets. NHAI will consider organizing the road assets into a special purpose vehicle and use the innovative mobilization structures like toll operate and transfer and infrastructure investment funds. Strengthening the railway networks and enhancing railways carrying capacity has been a major focus of the government. Railway capex for the year 2018-19 has been pegged at ₹1,48,528 crores. A large part of the capex is devoted to its capacity creation. 18,000 kilometers of doubling and third and fourth line works of 5,000 kilometers of gauge conversion would eliminate capacity constraints and transform almost the entire network into broad gauge. There are also significant movement in the achievement of the physical target of the railways itself. We are moving fast towards optimal electrification of railway network. 4,000 kilometers targeted for commissioning during 2017-18. Work on eastern and western dedicated freight corridor is also in full swing. Adequate number of rolling stock, 12,000 wagons, 5,160 coaches, and approximately 700 locomotives are being produced during the year 2018-19. A major program has been initiated to strengthen the infrastructure, goods shed, and fast-track commissioning of the private buildings. A safety-first policy with allocation of adequate funds under the Rashtriya Railway Sanrakshana Kosh is a cornerstone of the railways. Focus on safety. Maintenance of track infrastructure is being given special attention. Over 3,600 kilometers of track renewal is targeted during the current year. Other major steps include increasing use of technology, fog safe, train protection and warning system. A decision has been taken to eliminate 4,267 unmanned railway crossings in the broad gauge network in the next 2 years. Redevelopment of 600 major railway stations is being taken up by the Indian Railway Station Development Company Limited. All stations with more than 25,000 footfalls will have escalators. All railway stations and trains will be progressively provided with Wi-Fi, CCTVs, and will also provide at all station and on trains to enhance security passengers. Modern train sets with state-of-art amenities and features are being designed at the integrated coach factory Perambur. First such train set will be commissioned during 2018-19. The Mumbai transport system, which is the lifeline of the city, is being expanded and augmented to add 90 kilometers of double line track at a cost of ₹11,000 crores. 150 kilometers of additional suburban network is being planned at a cost of ₹40,000 crores, including elevated corridors in some sections. A suburban network of approximately 160 kilometers is also being at an estimated cost of ₹17,000 crores is being planned to cater to the growth of the Bengaluru metropolitan. Foundation of the Mumbai-Ahmedabad bullet train project, India's first high-speed rail project, was laid on September 14, 2017. An institute is coming up at Vadodara to train the manpower required for the high-speed railway project. For the first 3 years, the domestic air passenger traffic grew at 18%, and our airline companies placed orders for more than 900 aircrafts. Regional connectivity scheme, UDAN, initiated by the Government of India last year, shall connect 56 unserved airports and 31 unserved helipads in the country. Operations have already started at 16 such airports. सरकार की इस पहल से हवाई चप्पल पहनने वाले नागरिक भी अब हवाई जहाज की यात्रा कर सकते हैं। एयरपोर्ट अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया हैज 124 एयरपोर्ट्स। वी प्रपोज टू एक्सपैंड आवर एयरपोर्ट कैपेसिटी मोर देन 5 टाइम्स टू हैंडल 1 बिलियन ट्रिप्स अ ईयर अंडर द न्यू इनिशिएटिव। नवनिर्माण बैलेंस शीट ऑफ एयरपोर्ट अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया शैल बी लिवरेज टू रेज मोर रिसोर्सेज फॉर फंडिंग एंड एक्सपेंशन। आर एफर्ट्स टू सेट अप अ कोलिशन ऑन द डिजास्टर रिजिलियंट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फॉर डेवलपिंग इंटरनेशनल गुड प्रैक्टिस appropriate standard and regulatory mechanism for resilient infrastructure development is moving well. I propose to allocate 60 crores for kickstarting the initiative. The government and the market regulators will then have taken necessary measures for developing and monetizing vehicles like the Infrastructure Investment Fund and the Real Estate Investment Fund. Government of India would monetize select CPSC SEs using the InvITs from next year. In the current year, we included in the scope of harmonized list of infrastructure, ropeways to promote tourism, logistic parks, and expanded the scope of railway infrastructure to include development of commercial land around the railway station. The Reserve Bank of India has issued guidelines to nudge corporates to access the bond market. SEBI will also consider mandating, beginning with large corporates, to meet about 1/4 of their financing needs from the bond market. Corporate bonds rated at BBB or equivalent are investment grade. In India, most regulators permit bonds with the AA rating only as eligible for investment. It is now to move from AA to A grade ratings. The government has and the concerned regulators will take necessary action. We will take reform measures with respect to the stamp duty regime on the financial securities transactions in consultation with the states, and make necessary amendments in the Indian Stamp Act. International Financial Service Center at the Gift City, which has become operational, needs a coherent and integrated regulatory framework to fully develop and to compete with other offshore financial centers. The government will establish a unified authority for regulating all financial services in the IFCS in Delhi, in India. Global economy is transforming into a digital economy thanks to the development of the cutting-edge technologies in the digital space. Machine learning, artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, 3D printing and like. Initiatives such as the Digital India, Startup India, Make in India would help to establish itself as a knowledge and digital society. Niti Aayog will establish a national program to direct our efforts in the area of artificial intelligence, including research and development of its applications. Combining cyber and physical systems with greater potential to transform not only innovation ecosystems but also our economies and the way of life. To invest in research, training and skilling in robotics, artificial intelligence, digital manufacturing, big data intelligence, quantum communications and the art of things. Department of Science and Technology will launch a mission on cyber space in support of establishment of centers of excellence. I have doubled their allocation on the Digital India program to ₹3,073 in 2018-19. The task of connecting 1 lakh gram panchayats to high-speed optic fiber network has been completed under phase 1 of the BharatNet program. This has enabled broadband access to cover 20 crore rural Indians in about 2,50,000 villages. The government also proposes to step up 5 lakh Wi-Fi hotspots, which will provide a broadband access to 5 crore rural citizens. I have provided rupees 10,000 crores in 2018-19 for creation and augmentation of this telecom infrastructure. To harness the benefits of emerging new technologies, particularly the fifth generation technologies and its adoption, the Department of Telecom will support the establishment of the indigenous 5G test bed at IIT Chennai. Distributed ledger system on the blockchain technology allows organization of any chain of records or transactions without the need of intermediaries. The government does not consider cryptocurrencies as legal tender or coin and will take all measures to eliminate the use of these crypto assets in financing illegitimate activities or as part of the payment system. The government will explore use of blockchain technology proactively for ushering in a digital economy. The system of toll payment physically by cash at the road plazas is being fast replaced by the FASTags and other electronic payment systems to make roads seamless. Number of FASTags have gone up from about 60,000 to December 2016 to more than 10 lakh now. From December 2017, all class M and N vehicles are being sold only with the FASTag tags. The Government of India will come out with a policy to introduce a toll system on pay-as-you-use basis. In order to create employment and aid growth, government's estimated budgetary and extra budgetary expenditure on infrastructure for 18-19 is being increased to rupees 5.97 lakh crores as against an estimated expenditure of rupees 4.94 lakh crores in 17-18. Details are given in Annexure 3. Our armed forces have played a stellar role in meeting the challenges we have been facing on the borders as well as managing the internal security of both Jammu and Kashmir and Northeast. I would like to place on record our appreciation for the efforts and the sacrifices made by the police services in defending the interests of the nation. Ever since the NDA government assumed office, a lot of emphasis was given to the modernizing and enhancing of the operational capability of the defense forces. A number of initiatives have been taken to develop and nurture intrinsic defense production capable of making the nation self-reliant for meeting our defense needs and ensuring adequate budget support to our priority. We have opened up private investment in the defense production, including liberalizing foreign direct investment. We have taken measures to develop two defense industrial production corridors in the country. The government will bring out an industry-friendly defense production policy in 2018 to promote the domestic production by public sector, private sector, and the MSMEs. Aadhaar has provided an identity to every Indian. Aadhaar has eased delivery of so many public services to our people. Every enterprise, major or small, also needs a unique ID. The government will involve a scheme to assign every individual enterprise in India a unique ID. To carry on business reforms for ease of doing business deeper and in every state of India, Government of India has identified 372 basic business reform actions. Each state will take up these reforms and simplifications in a mission mode, constructively competing with each other. Evaluating the performance under this program will now be based on the feedbacks. Capital of the Food Corporation of India is being restructured to enhance equity and to raise a long-term debt for meeting a standard working requirement. Budgeting of the Government of India's contribution in equity and the debt of the metro ventures floated by state governments will be streamlined. The Department of Commerce will be developing a national logistic portal as a single window online marketplace to link all stakeholders. The Government of India will
has approved the listing of 14 CPSEs, including two insurance companies, on the stock exchanges. The government has initiated a process of strategic disinvestment of 24 CPSEs. This will include the strategic privatization of the Air India. Process of acquisition of the Hindustan Petroleum Corporation by ONGC has been successfully completed. Three public sector general insurance companies, National Insurance Company Limited, United Insurance Assurance Company Limited, United India Assurance Company Limited, and the Oriental India Insurance Company Limited will be merged into a single insurance entity and will be subsequently listed. The Government of India introduced the exchange-traded fund Bharat 22 to raise 14,500 crores, which was oversubscribed in all segments. DIPAM will continue with more ETF offers, including a debt ETF. 2017-18 budget estimates for disinvestment were pegged at the highest ever level of 72,500 crores. I am happy to inform this House that we have already exceeded this target. I am assuming a receipt of rupees 1 lakh crores from disinvestment for 17-18. I am setting a disinvestment target of 80,000 crores for 2018-19. Bank recapitalization program has been launched with bonds at rupees 80,000 crores being issued this year. The program has been integrated with an ambitious reform agenda and the rubric of an enhanced access to service excellence program. This recapitalization will pave the way for public sector banks to lend an additional rupees 5 lakh crores. It is proposed to allow strong regional rural banks to raise capital from the market to enable them to increase its credit to the rural economy. The National Housing Bank is being amended to transfer its equity from the Reserve Bank to the Government of India. The Indian Post Office Act, Provident Fund Act, and the National Savings Certificate Act are being amalgamated, and certain additional people-friendly measures are being introduced. To provide the RBI an instrument to manage excess liquidity, the RBI Act is being amended to institutionalize the collateralized deposit facility, Securities and Exchange Control Board of India Act 1992, Securities Contract Regulation Act 1956, and Depositories Act 1996 are being amended to streamline the adjudication procedures and to provide penalties of certain infractions. These proposals are given in the finance bill. For easier access, links to all detailed demands for grants will be provided at indiagovern.in. The government will also consider the feasibility of providing disclosed financial information in a machine-readable form. The government is transforming method of disposal at its business by introduction of an e-office and other e-governance initiatives in the central ministries and departments. These initiatives are given in Annexure 4. The government will formulate a comprehensive gold policy to develop gold as an asset class. The government will also establish a system of a consumer-friendly, trade-efficient system of regulated gold exchanges in the country. Gold monetization scheme will be revamped to enable people to open a hassle-free gold deposit account. The outward direct investment from India has grown to US $15 billion per annum. The government will review existing guidelines and processes to bring a coherent and integrated outward direct investment. Hybrid instruments are suitable for attracting a foreign investment in several niche areas, such as startups and venture capital firms. The government will involve a separate policy for hybrid instruments. Now, this is important, madam. The emoluments of the President, the Vice President and the Governors were last revised on 1st January 2006. These emoluments are proposed to be revised to rupees 5 lakhs for President, rupees 4 lakhs for the Vice President and rupees 3.5 lakhs per month for the Governors.
सुनिए. देयर हैज बीन अ कंसिडरेबल पब्लिक डिबेट विद रिगार्ड टू द इमोल्यूमेंट्स पेड टू मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट. The present practice allows the recipients to fix their own emoluments, which invites criticism. I am therefore proposing necessary changes to refix the salary, constituency allowance, other expenses and meeting allowances payable to members of parliament with effect from 1st April 2018. The law will also provide for an automatic revision of emoluments every 5 years, indexed to inflation. The law will also provide, I repeat, for an automatic revision of emoluments every 5 years, indexed to inflation. I am sure the members of parliament will welcome this initiative and which will not suffer any criticism in future. Our country will commemorate the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, the father of the nation, on 2nd October 2019 to 2nd October 2020. The government and the people of India will rededicate themselves through actions to ideals of the Mahatma taught and lived by. A national committee chaired by the Prime Minister, which includes the chief ministers of the state, representatives from across the political spectrum, Gandhian thinkers and eminent persons from all walks of life have been constituted to formulate a commemoration program. My government has earmarked a sum of rupees 150 crores for the year 2018-19 for the activities leading to the commemoration.